Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, Sean Locke, John Richardson, Jason Manford, Rasheed Hannity, Sam Simmons, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, the word highbrow comes from the late 19th century when it was believed that the size of a person's forehead was connected to the size of their brain? And it makes sense, after all, two of Britain's foremost intellectuals are Ant McPartlin and Sean Locke. The largest ever online maths competition had over a million contestants. It was like the X Factor, except literally everyone had a tragic backstory. And latrinology is the study of graffiti on toilet walls. You might think it's a weird thing to study, but in my experience, it's the best way of getting the telephone number of your mum. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Sean Locke is soon to be travelling nationwide with his new tour. Great news, not for his audience so much, but certainly for his family, who are staying at home. And joining Sean tonight, it's Jason Manford. Hey. Jason loves musicals and has starred in The Producers and Sweeney Todd, though surprisingly for someone who loves musical theatre so much, he's actually got five kids. Up against them this evening, it's John Richardson. John actually reminds me of Tom Cruise, mainly because he reminds me of Dustin Hoffman in Rain Man, which reminds me of Tom Cruise. John's teammate, Rasheed Connaughty. Rasheed Connaughty, if the game of countdown is the Titanic, let's welcome the iceberg. Rasheed, I read on Twitter that you recently got into a bit of bother in Dublin. What happened?
Seagull shut in my face.
It's good luck, isn't it?
It didn't feel very lucky. It went right in my eye, and I had to get my friend. She had to, like, claw it out of my eye, because I was like, I'm blind, I'm blind!
She clawed it out of your eye.
It was like 4 in the morning, and she was like, I've got it, I get it out.
That's quite... because the seagull would have had to come in, like a bit like the Dam Busters. Right now, angle, and then just go up, unless you were walking around like that.
I was eating, so there's chances I was dropping food.
A good way of stopping that happening is going to bed at a reasonable hour.
Well, you've never been shat on by a bird?
Not at 4 in the morning.
Wow. Yeah, in my experience.
I'm frankly sickened. Sean.
Yes?
If you were to have your dream dinner party, who would be there?
Well, I thought, well, maybe I'll get Gandhi, Cleopatra, Henry VIII, Napoleon. Then I thought, oh, I'll be the only one not in fancy dress. So what I came up with in the end, I thought, the people I'd really like at dinner party, I'd like Uncle Ben, Colonel Sanders, Dr. Otker, Ronald McDonald. Basically, all people who've served me food which I've regretted eating.
Okay, John, here's a question for you. Have you ever Googled yourself?
I have done, yes.
What did you find when you Googled yourself?
A very sexually aggressive mum's net discussion.
What did they say they were?
Someone said, I quite like that little weird one. And then began a series of segues on what would need to be done to me. I'm going to get the shit beaten out of me, Jimmy, by a series of mothers and then tied to a bed and sodomised. That's the rough thread.
Are you sure they're mum?
Jason, you're doing a lot of acting these days. How do you prepare for your roles?
Just get the script and then just pretend you're someone else. It's basically pretending for grown-ups.
That's actually very similar to one of the reviews I read about you.
What have you played? What are the recent roles?
I was Adolfo Pirelli in Sweeney Todd. And then I did a thing for BBC, Ordinary Lies, where I just played myself, really. Just a... I put on 2 stone for that part. I mean, nobody asked me to, but I just thought... get into the guy's mind.
Have you got a mascot this evening?
A what?
A mascot.
Oh, I think I've misheard that. Mascot?
Yeah, mascot.
I got like a maths cot.
That's some of the best acting I've ever seen.
Wow. Okay. John, have you got a mascot?
Mascot?
John. You've got to get into character. Go again.
Have you got a mascot, Jason?
Mascot? Oh, lovely. Oh. You've got to be doing something else.
Ideally, you want to be middle of summer.
Have you got a mascot, Jason?
Mascot?
It's an acting masterclass, isn't it?
I do it like this. Put it in there. That's me.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
No, but I've got a mascot.
Nice. I'll tell you, Derek.
Bang! Out of the park.
John, have you got a mascot?
It's not so much a mascot as a sort of ideal. I've realised I've been taking Countdown quite seriously and I've been playing quite selfishly. I've been playing for my own glory. And I realise this week, more than ever, it's about getting the most out of my team. Because Roshi and shit. So, I've been reading a managerial handbook on how to be a better leader. And I will be working this week to get the most not only out of myself but out of Roisin. So I've got my the slogan.
Why are you undoing your top?
That was good acting, that one. She really like she wasn't turned on then. I really believed you felt sick then. This is our slogan. This is how I'm gonna lead.
Know the way, show the way, go the way.
Yeah. It's a longer slogan than that, but I only have a small chest. But I'm going to lead Roisin and I together through eye contact and reassuring phrases.
Sure.
It's going to be all right.
Oh. Roisin, have you got a mascot?
So, I get very stressed on this show, and see why, old Creepy McCreepson.
God.
It's a massage, so I'm going to get stressed.
I think I know what kind of a massage that gives.
No, it's not that. You roll it. So it's like a massage thing.
Could you just hold it up by the balls? Yeah.
Okay, if you're going to be rude about me, but it's really good, and it's really genuinely works. It's very, releases a lot of stress, a lot of tension, and I thought if I get relaxed and stuff, then my brain might relax into it and I might get the answers.
Do you know what? John loves physical contact, so just give him...
Let's do it on John.
Here we go.
Look at the comfort.
Relax into it. Breathe into it. Just breathe. You've got to breathe through your nose. Out for your mouth. It's making horrible noises.
Okay, well, you pop that away, but not... Sean, have you got a mascot?
Mascot? Yes, I do, Jimmy. I need a bit of space for my mascot.
Of course
need
you
a
do. Room.
Now, as we all know, recently, the government introduced a new bill about plastic bags when you go shopping.
Oh, yeah.
Pay 5p. Very good. I think very good. But a lot of people complain, saying they don't always carry bags around with them. This is a perfect system to replace it. It's a coat that you wear that you can put all your shopping in. Now, first off, I wear this bandolier I know I'd have sausages in there. There's some canistan there, anisole, a few sausages, some moisturiser, lubricant, and
lubricant, sausages, and anusol. Wow. That's a hell of a weekend, isn't it?
I put the coat on, right? Put the coat on.
So you wear this to go shopping, so you haven't got to buy a plastic bag for 5p?
Yeah, you don't need to carry bags around. It's just the coat. It comes with it. And, I mean, I might need a bit of help from Jason here, but, for example...
Sure.
OK, I've got 2 baguettes, right. Where do they go? They go in the quiver.
This is amazing.
Where do I put my Pringles, Jason? In the epaulettes.
What's that there? Oh, in there. I thought, well, that's called. Right.
Yeah. So yeah, you've got epaulettes there. Right. I've got a chicken. Oh, what a drag. I haven't got a bag. Where do I put it? Easy. I got this off the back of an airplane seat. Okay. We got some tins here. Ba-dum!
Oh, wow.
Ba-dum!
That's incredible.
It's great if you haven't got money for a bag, but also if you were to be shoplifting.
Mm. I think it's a little bit obvious for shoplifting. There's a frozen section, as you can see.
Of course there is, yeah. No,
the fish fingers in there, like that. Also, you know, for your little items, whoops, little bit of an epaulette slip up there. This is the deli hat, and you just get your stuff from the deli. Right, some pork pies there, get them in there after you pay for them. There, that's lovely, get those in there. I feel like I'm a Blue Peter. Any other bits? Oh, yes, yeah, that, now this.
What I like is you've not actually used the pocket.
This. Because you'd have that free for
like
stuff.
Like your wallet and...
Yeah,
and
tissues.
And that, of course.
And,
you basket that bags. Help,
and, of course, milk. Oh, what a drag. Got to carry milk around with you. No, you don't. You just pour it in there. And then there's your milk done. So there you are. And you could hang your bananas on there.
Yeah. That's a real success story.
Yeah. I do.
And, hang on, let's get the full look.
Oh!
Don't lean forward, otherwise milk's going to go.
Careful.
Oh God, imagine that. Oh. And then you just go out the shop.
A great mascot. OK. Over in Dictionary Corner, we've got Sam Simmons.
Hello. Hello.
When he was growing up, Australian Sam wanted to be a vet and worked in a zoo. It's a shame that he didn't keep it up. There is a gap in the market now for an Australian animal expert since we lost Steve Irwin and Rolf Harris. Sam, the British audience might not be familiar with you. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
38-year-old Piscean from Adelaide in South Australia. I do a very good impression of a... I dare say, like, a Super Mario brother battling a drug and alcohol problem.
You used to work in as a zookeeper, that's true, right?
Yeah.
What was your favourite bit about working in a zoo?
Probably this bit, just right here, which is a deer's hoof. Yeah, it's my favourite part. Sometimes I let him be free and he goes like running. Like... What?
What do you think of Manchester and Salford? What do you think of it up here?
I only found out today that Coronation Street was set here. I thought it was like elsewhere, but this is a real place.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's like.
Because you're from Home and Away, aren't you?
Yeah, totally. Oh, it's not called that in Australia. It's called Sand Sluts.
OK, with Sam, of course, is Susie Dent. Susie, Sam is Australian. What contribution have the Australians made, if any, to the English language?
Lots of brilliant expressions, but I can't do an Australian accent, so can you do them for me?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Don't come the raw prawn with me.
Don't come the raw prawn with... I'm trying to do an English accent. Don't come the raw prawn with me.
What does that mean?
It means, like, don't shit me, don't bullshit me.
But why a raw prawn?
Because you don't want to eat a raw prawn.
OK, that's one of my questions.
OK. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley, she's smart, funny and great company. She really ticks all the boxes, unless one of the boxes is marked good at dancing. Rachel, it says here you've started to experiment with Russian food. How's that going?
Yeah, I love a bit of Russian food. There's one place I had some Russian food, it's called a banya. So it's like a Russian sauna. So you go there in a bikini and this Russian guy in a felt hat makes you cover your eyes with a birch branch and then he hits you with one. And then you dip yourself in an ice bucket of water and then in the plunge pool and then you go and have more pickles and sausages and vodka. And then you kind of repeat.
You've still got the blindfold on with the pickles and the sausages.
Yeah, it's kind of across the street.
Can we just look up Gullible and see? Okay, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this: the Countdown Table Tennis Table. OK, let's count down, everyone, for the first time today. Sean and Jason, you pick the letters.
We'll have a vowel.
Thanks, Jason.
Can we just do it like... E. Yeah, we'll have four vowels and then... Four
no,
vowels?
Three.
No, three vowels. Vowels. So three vowels.
And four a. consonants, please.
P. B. T. S.
Okay. Another consonant, please.
M.
And another consonant.
And the last one, Y.
OK, and your time starts now. Practice, love. John, what have you got?
A six.
Sean, how many you got?
Six.
Jason?
Five.
Okay, fives and sixes. I suppose we should ask.
Roisin, I believe in you, and I think you are the person to drive this team... Yep.
How many have you got, Roisin?
Five.
All right, what's your five, Roisin?
Toupee. With an A.
Toupee with an A.
T-A-U-P-E.
Is that a colour? Taupe. That's a colour.
Taupe.
Taupe. Taupe.
So you're pronouncing taupe toupee. But, I mean, still counts.
Yeah. Still got it, right?
It is a word through no fault of your own. It is a word. Jason.
Busty.
Sean, you're six.
Steamy.
Ooh.
Steamy.
Steamy and
all right,
busty.
Herbs.
I'd definitely go there.
John, you're six.
Upbeat. The way I am about our future together as a partnership.
6 points to both teams. Susie, Sam, could they have done any better?
There's a seven in there, subtype.
OK. So at the end of that, both teams have 6 points. On to our first numbers round. OK, John, Roisin, your turn to pick the numbers.
We would like...
one from the top.
Yes. And another one from the top.
What? Oh. What?
And a four.
And a four.
I'll keep four small ones, please.
All right, no fours, but you have got four.
Thanks,
small
Rachel.
Ones. They are three, seven, one, nine, and the big ones 25 and 50. And the target 525.
Should we? Yeah, hit it again.
Yeah.
No?
Oh, come on. I had that.
Okay, and your time starts now.
Thank you.
So the target was 987. John, did you get it?
I got 991.
OK. Roisin?
975.
Ooh. Sure, did you get it?
982.
What about you, Jason?
Yeah, same, 982.
Did you copy his?
I didn't, actually. I'm all right this one. It's the letters I'm fucked up.
So, John, you were the closest. How did you do it?
7 times 3...
21.
Minus 1.
20.
Times 50.
1,000.
Minus 9.
991, 4 away.
So, 7 points to John. Rachel, could it be done?
Yes, if you say 50 times 3, 150. Minus 9, 141, and times that by 7.
Time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Sam Simmons, what have you got for us?
I'm gonna do all the things that shit me.
The things that what, sorry?
Shit me.
Like, annoy you.
Annoy me. Things right. That shit me. Like, oh, okay. That's a thing. Like, do you not say that? Do you not give people the shits?
Occasionally, if I undercook something.
Well, no, it's the reverse of that. So that's like just things that annoy kind of thing.
Okay. Things
like,
that annoy you.
Like, so you're the, like you things... are giving me the shits right now.
Well, I apologise.
Things that shit me.
When you hear car tyres screeching, but then no bang. The fact that there's multi-millionaire cats on the internet and they don't even know it because they're stupid fucking cats.
Three of them that exist! Cats that are multi-millionaires just for being fucking cats, people!
Do cats on the internet, even though that they are famous? Do cats on the internet, even though that they are famous?
There we go.
Really confusing television commercials. Reliability, integrity, inspiration, synergy, refreshment, be who you are. The Waffle House.
Things that shit me.
Having a regret in your life.
I've never finished an entire chapstick.
Things that shit me.
People who forget to take off their bicycle helmets inside shops.
Do you guys got croissants?
Things that shit me.
Iceberg lettuces.
Iceberg lettuce is the most banal vegetable in the vegetable patch. I've got no time for an iceberg lettuce, people! Don't like it!
You know, the iceberg lettuce is good for. It's good for a little bit of this. Sean, you're on the way out. Namaste, my friend. Namaste, my bull brother. Namaste. Namaste, my friend. Namaste. Here he is. Hello, mate. Namaste, my friend. Namaste. Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sam Simmons. And here is your teaser. The words are grab pipe. The clue is just squeeze the bag and blow. That's grab pipe. Just squeeze the bag and blow. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were grab pipe. The clue was just squeeze the bag and blow. It was, of course, bagpiper. So John and Roisin are in the lead. Time to mix things up a little bit now. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Roisin. Roisin, your turn to choose the letters.
Can I have a vowel, please, Rachel?
You can indeed. E.
And another vowel.
O.
And another vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant.
P.
And another consonant.
H.
And another consonant.
R.
And a vowel.
That's the right word, yeah.
You.
How many have I done, though? And another consonant.
M.
And another vowel, please. Too many vowels.
And the last one, another E.
And your time starts now. Roisin, what have you got? How many?
Four.
Sean, what have you got?
Six.
OK, Roisin, you're four?
I've got five now. Fume.
Fume.
I've got it wrong. No.
what was your six, Sean?
Humper.
I don't think humper's in. No, I think it's humpback and humpless.
Really? You don't think it's in?
Is somebody who humps stuff?
I'll just look it up in my pocket.
And maybe double check fume as well.
Yeah, while you're there, while you got it open.
Humpless. Hump off. But it's just not in the dictionary. It's obviously not used often enough, Sean. You need to use humper more often.
So no points to either team. Susie, what could they have had?
Rehome is there for six.
Rehome?
Yeah.
So at the end of that, Sean and Jason have six, John and Roisin have 13. Right, now time for John and Jason to go head-to-head in the numbers round. Oh. Jason, your pick.
One from the top and then the other ones that are not from the top.
Little ones. Right, the little ones. 9, 10, 7, 1 and 7, and the big one, 50. And the target, 492.
OK, and your time starts now. Okay, so Jason and John, did you get it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Jason, how'd you get it?
50 times 10 is 500.
Yeah.
And 7 plus 1 is 8.
Okay, 10 points to both teams. Okay, time to go once again to Dictionary Corner. Sam, what have you got for us?
All right, I've drawn some pictures, but we all know that art's a bit boring. So I've decided to entwine it with music and roller skates. Problem being, I can't roller skate heaps good, but we're gonna give it a little go. All right, cue the music. All right. It's a Meskimo. It's a Meskimo. It's a Mexican Eskimo hybrid. Which is politically incorrect, so it's otherwise known as an Inuit Latino or an Inuino. This is a self-portrait. It's a self-portrait. There's a self-portrait of me just wearing little shorts and whatnot. And that's what I look like when my leg come off. This is known as a hors d'oeuvre. A hors d'oeuvre. It's a half vol-au-vent, half lady of the night. Here's a problem picture. This is Neil. He got it all wrong. He thought he was coming out of the closet. Okay. Knock, knock! Yeah.
Fridge. Fridge cat. It's a ham, Jesus, and tomato toasted sandwich. This picture here, this is a Wookie Goldberg. Sam Simmons, everyone, Sam Simmons. Right. I'm getting better at roles, guys. And here's your teaser. The words are let's fart. The clue is it makes me feel good. That's let's fart. It makes me feel good. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were let's fart. The clue was it makes me feel good. It was, of course, flatters. OK, before we get on with the game, time for the countdown bonus challenge, a chance for our teams to win some valuable points. Normally, we test our players' maths and English skills, but tonight we'll be testing their acting ability. So, Sean, you've done a bit of acting in your time, haven't you?
You could say that, Jimmy.
John, do you fancy yourself as a bit of an actor?
Mascot.
John and Roisin, you go first. Here's your script. Okay. I'd like you to do a scene from When Harry Met Sally.
OK.
But to make it a bit more of a challenge, I'd like you to play Sally, John.
Is this part of the show, or is this just you? Wanting to see John in a wig.
This cheap tat is not a wig. It will inhibit my performance.
If I don't, I'm going to grow mine out.
OK, so let's have your acting skills.
So I'm yellow and you're not yellow.
Well,
that's how the professionals talk. You'll hear that on film sets. You'll hear Daniel Day-Lewis go, I'm yellow, you're not yellow. Highlighted line.
I've never seen the film. Where is it set? Newcastle?
It's in New York.
You know what? I'm so glad I never got involved with you.
Why are you getting so upset?
What's the dog from the Magic Roundabout called?
Why are you getting so upset? It's not about you.
Yes, it is. You are a human affront to all women, and I am a woman.
Hey, I don't feel great about this, but I don't hear anyone complaining.
You're out the door too fast.
I think they have an okay time.
I think your mustache is upside down. How do you know that they really?
What do you say, that they fake an orgasm?
It's possible.
You don't think I could tell the difference?
No.
Get out of here.
Oh. Oh. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, right there. Shove it right up my... I've gone off script a bit. That's it, the whole ham. Right up there.
I'm so sorry.
Just quickly, I've just realised this looks like if I was transitioning. Like, because you know it's popular now.
Sean, Jason, I've got a scene for you. I've chosen for you Return of the Jedi. So Jason, you're Yoda. Could you pass those over to...
This is one of the Star Trek films. Star Wars films.
Sean, that's your wig. The wig's for you.
Oh, the wig's for you, apparently.
I think fucking shove your wig.
Sean.
What?
Wig.
You can't make people put wigs on.
You've already had an iceberg. Even
Hitler didn't do that.
Even Hitler.
Even Hitler didn't make people wear wigs.
Or maybe Jason just hold it like above his head the whole time.
There you are, Jason. Seriously, Sean, you telling me you don't need a wig, it's just you being in denial. It... it looks like you're dreaming of hair. I do have hair. He hasn't got any hair.
I've got hair on the sides, mate.
To be honest, there's not a massive difference. Other than you've styled it and you've just come as you are, there's actually not a massive difference between
yeah,
the two.
I just don't dye mine.
Ladies, please!
Hey,
Jason. OK, Jason and Sean, Return of the Jedi.
That face you make, look I so old to young eyes.
No, of course not.
I do, yes, I do. Sick have I become. Oh, no. Sick have I become. I didn't really...
I should have read ahead.
It's amazing to see you turn that quickly, though.
Master Yoda, you can't die.
Twilight is upon me. I've seen that film. Twilight is upon me, and soon night must fall.
But I need your help.
No more training do you require.
Except acting training.
Master Yoda, is Darth Vader my father?
Your father, he is, told you, did he?
Yes.
Unexpected this is, and unfortunate.
Unfortunate that I know the truth.
No, unfortunate that you rushed to face him. That incomplete was your training, not ready for the burden, were you?
Well, I'm sorry.
Well, I think we can all agree Sean and Jason were the best there, so 5 points to them. Round of applause for our actors. OK, on with the game. Sean and Jason, your turn to choose the letters.
Can we have a vowel, please, Rachel?
O.
And another vowel?
E.
And another vowel, please.
O.
Oh. Consonant, please.
T.
Another consonant, please.
W.
And another one, please.
V.
And another...
Deep.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another consonant, please.
And last one, S.
OK, and your time starts now. So, Sean, how many letters?
Six.
Oh, Jason?
Four.
John?
Six.
Roisin?
Five.
So, Jason, you're four?
Two!
Two, so it's slightly more than two.
Yeah, so it's... No, it's the second half of an owl, cos he's PC, he doesn't want to call anyone a name, so he's gone. Two! Is that in there?
The twit is, but not the twoo.
Roisin, you're five?
Wodes.
Ooh.
Wodes. And what does wodes mean, Roisin?
What cast do I on?
Is it in the dictionary?
It's not anymore, but I think it was. I think it was passive Anglo-Saxon English.
OK, John, you're six?
Vested.
Ooh.
Ooh. Sean?
Stowed.
So 6 points for both teams. Sam, Susie, could they have done any better?
What? Is that devout?
Devotes.
Devotes. Well, I had devotes.
OK. The scores at the moment, Sean and Jason have 27, John and Roisin have 29. And here's your final teaser. The words are gay wangs. The clue is hello, sailor. That's gay wangs. Hello, sailor. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were gay wangs. The clue was hello, sailor. It was, of course, gangways. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Roisin, your turn to choose the letters.
The management book says that little rewards are important, and I think I haven't been giving you enough rewards, so if we do well in this letters game, you can have a reward.
Ooh! How he's been training me!
Put on the Dougal moustache if you're going to be doing that dog noise.
All right, Perv. There you go.
I'm sensing that you're not happy with the training techniques I've been using. And I'm going to tell you now that there are no treats for you. You're not allowed one of these. You were going to have one of these, and now you're not going to have it.
I am the one. I bought everything without even knowing what the treat was.
A delicious treat.
Sorry, John, are they dog biscuits?
I've been studying carefully how to be the leader of the pack.
What's the book?
It's Patricia McConnell. I'll be honest, when I bought it, I didn't read the subtitle. I thought it was a management book called How to Be the Leader of the Pack. I didn't realise it was called And Have Your Dog Love You For It.
Can Daddy have a biscuit? Daddy would like a biscuit.
It's the daddy part of it I'm really having trouble with. I feel like if I give you a biscuit, I endorse this behaviour. Which
Try
I
Papa.
Do not.
Can Papa have a cookie?
We'd like a consonant, please. A vowel, please.
I.
A consonant, please.
D.
Another consonant, please.
N.
A vowel, please.
U.
Another consonant, please.
R.
A vowel, please.
I.
A consonant, please.
B.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. Ooh, ooh, you.
Oh, dear.
OK, and the time starts now. You got four? John?
Six.
Sean?
Four.
Jason? Four. Yeah. OK. You're four, Jason.
A bird.
Rind for me.
Rind for you?
I had bird.
John?
You'll kick yourself, Jason. Unbird. It was there when you had a bird and then you haven't.
No unbirdie, sorry, John.
OK, 4 points to both teams. Yeah, 4 points. Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, I noticed here.
Bruin.
What's a Bruin?
A Bruin is a bear in a fairy tale.
Oh, right. Why don't they just say bear?
Okay, so Sean and Jason have 31, John and Roisin have 33. Ooh. So today we've got a crucial countdown conundrum. So fingers on buzzers. Are you ready? Okay, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Time starts now.
Is it,
Paul...
Paul what?
Paul Lottery. Patrolery. Palatry. Palatry. Palatory. Oh,
Let's have a look and see.
Patrollery is not
Patrol. Oh, Patrail. Paul.
Oh, listen to that. Our Countdown audience have gone, well, that was never going to happen. So the final scores are Sean and Jason have 31 points, but tonight's winners with 33 are John and Roisin. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown table tennis table. Go and have a game. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
More same time next week. Jimmy's back again, but not in charge on E4. That's Kevin McHale's job for brand new Virtually Famous, Tuesday at 10. But next up here on Channel 4, First Dates is back. Odds are 500-1 on romance for a retired bookmaker, or so he says. A bet on love on the way.